Hi, welcome back. And then this time you're going to see back-to-back transfer. And then I made a targeted collection, and then I will now go on and we'll now have a look at it on the same Zinox only. So let me go there and then let me sign in. So before I create the sales order, I will now go on and check the MSP default. Fine, whether anybody has changed it or not, you know, have a look at it. The first activity is what? Because since many of you are working simultaneously, when you work, you see whether your profile is there or not. Manage personal admin profile. So go to this place and then we'll now query the MSP default. MSP default personal inventory now. So let's see. It is now pointing to my only. Fine. Okay, that's okay. Fine. It's first ensure it and then afterwards create a sales order. I will now give a cancel now. So my is pointing to it. I'm going to click on it. Now go and get a sales order for this. So go to the order management and then order management and then let us create an order. So click on create order. Drop it down. And then choose your US-1 business unit. It's computer rentals. Click on it. I will now populate my item. D011 and then give a tab now. So I'm now going to use a back-to-back transfer now. Is a 1-2 item. I click on it. So go there. I will now go further. There are 4 quantities on this now. Click on add now. You're adding it. Now click on it. And here. Now go to the supply. And then it's 001 from there. I'm going to ship it to the customers from 002 to 0201. I'm now going to bring it. And then I will now do the shipping from this place now. So the order is getting submitted now. So 97380 is the order. I will now go to the actions and then I will now switch to fulfillment view. And then I go to the fulfillment lines. And then I click on this now, orchestration process. And then I will wait for it to go in proceed. Now, the reservation will be replaced by an orchestration request for supply actually. So once when it is scheduled. Scheduling indicates that org has been collected actually. The inventory org pointed to on the shipping barrows on the header. Fine, that is collected. That is what it is. So request for orchestration supply is not coming and now. So now pass is started. So most probably it will not get. If it is coming to a waiting, that means what? There is some panga. Fine. By releasing the pass, it may not really work actually. So it has not got completed. Then supply request is complete and then it will be progressing into awaiting shipping. Ship back to back is now started now. The back to back goods, ship back to back goods is now started. It is now gone to awaiting shipping. I go to the fulfillment lines and then have a look at it now. I click on the fulfillment lines and then go there. Go to the supplier list. So here I have to get the order now. The order has to come over here now. So let me refresh it. It takes some time sometimes now. We'll now wait for some time now and then again refresh it. Yeah, this time I got the supply order number now. So go and then take it up, take a copy of it. It is basically a transfer order. Go there. I will now duplicate it. So right click and then duplicate. Right click and then duplicate. So we're going over there. So click on it. Go to the supply chain execution and then go to the supply orchestration. I click on the supply orchestration. And then here you click on it and then go there. And then go to the manage supply lines. And then we have taken a copy of the supply order number, the SKU number, we have taken it up and go there and then paste it over here. And then click on search. So once when you search for it, you'll now click on this now. So it's a transfer now. The source type is a transfer. So it's an in process and then it's the awaiting transfer order creation actually. It is now saying awaiting transfer order creation. So we already seen that this place, so here on the do score now. When the ESS job, fine, once when you submit the sales order, fine, it will be running the process supply chain orchestration internally, and that is responsible for creating the supply order actually. So that is responsible for it, but it is not created. So if you go to the buy, there won't be any recommendation at all. Fine, go there, click on it, there won't be any recommendation at all. The buy, there won't be any recommendation. The make also, there won't be any recommendation. And then if you go to the transfer, what happens, you'll be getting a recommendation. So the transfer order number is created. 133046 is the transfer order number. If you go to the execution documents, it will not show you all the documents. And then go to the orchestration plan, it will not show you the complete orchestration plan. So the transfer order, it will not get resolved. And then inter-organization shipment, it will now do it from the second hour to first hour. Then afterwards, a put away. Then afterwards, the fulfillment completion. All these things will be coming one after the other now. So go there. So it has now created a transfer order. If you go to the execution document, you can now see the transfer order is coming. So in the transfer area, it's coming back. It'll now, if you refresh it, it'll now come everywhere now. And go there. So it's 133.046 is the transfer order number. So let us now right click and then do it now. And right click and then duplicate it now. So let us now right click and then duplicate, and then we'll now go to the transfer order number. Go to the supply chain execution, and then you go to the inventory management. Click on it, go there. And then here, I will now go to manage transfer orders. So click on the manage transfer orders and then query for the transfer order. So the transfer order is number now. I go there. You give a PS now. This is not the number now. I'm not taking a copy actually. Click on the manage supply lines. It is 133046 is the number. So it's the 133046 is the number. I go there. So click on search now. We are going to search for the transfer order. So the transfer order is going to make the movement of material from the second lot to first lot. That is how it works now. I'm not querying the transfer order number. It has created a transfer order. Now I'm going to ship from 0 to R. So select it and then click on the view shipments and reception. And click on the view shipments and request. Four quantities are requested actually. If you click on the view shipments and request, requested is 4, shipped is nothing, received is nothing, delivered is nothing actually. Fine. Nothing everywhere, nothing is coming actually. So this item. Now let us now do the pick and then ship actually of this transfer order. So right click and then duplicate. Now I'm going to the manage shipment lines and then I'm going to pick release, pick confirmation, ship confirmation. We are do from the second org. So we are do the pick release, pick confirmation, and ship confirmation from the second org to first org. I'm going to click on it. I will now go to the supply chain execution and then I go to the inventory management. In this, I will now go to the shipments. Click on it and then I will now go to the shipments. Fine, drop it down and then go to the shipments now. So we are now in the shipments and then you go to the manage shipment lines and then here the order number is not a sales order number but the transfer order number. The order number is not a sales order number. Fine, go there, click on it. So it's the 133046 the one. I have to be on this property org. I had to be in the second org. Fine, click on the change org and then I will now change it to 002. I'm going to tab now and then click on OK. Organization is 002. And then click on it and search for it. The second org, I have to search for it now. Organization, I will go to the advanced sometimes. What happens? It gives you advanced is not working. Fine, I will now choose Atlanta. Fine, 80. Atlanta is the organization from there. They're doing it now. Fine. So this is not having an access to this now. Fine. So we don't have an access. I will now say Seattle, C-A-T. Click on search now. Fine. So Seattle is appearing, but it is not coming. So there is a data access problem on this now. Fine. Whether I click on this, there is a data access problem. But it is all inbuilt actually. Because if you give a tab and then click on search now, it is all inbuilt. I don't know why it's not coming now. So click on the advanced now. And then I will now say it's not blank. It has to come now. Right? It's a vision instance and then everything, the data access has been provided for every org actually. So click on search now. We have to get all the orgs over here. Oh, it's not coming. Okay. I will try one thing now. Fine, because I click on the order is not coming. 00 is not coming. Fine, I click on them. We're going to duplicate now. SCM00 instructor is not having it now. I will not try to give a data access for this. So go there. I will now go to this place. But I couldn't understand because there are some problems in these instances, but it's not so actually. So click on search now. I will now go to the manage data access. Manage data. Actually, vision instances, every org is basically eligible for it now. So go there. I will now give a plus now. Go there. Mine is what? SCM00.instructor now. I will not choose it now. So here, the role is what? OUSCM role, I think. OUSCM role. OUSCM role, go there. I will now give an app. I will now choose the inventory or now. Go the inventory or. And then I will now put 002 now. Now see whether it comes or not. So 002 is coming. So let me add this now. Fine, click on save and close. It is actually not required. I don't know. I'm not trying this now. Fine, click on it. So you go there again, what happens? You go there, click on the shipments now. Go to the shipments and then go to the manage shipment lines and then I will already change the org now. And click on change org. So click on 002. Organization, we give a search, blank search. Now see, only 001 is coming and not 002 is not coming at all. So what I did is I add the shipping manager role to my OUSCM role is sufficient actually. But I'm adding the shipping manager role to my user now, fine. SCM00.instructor, I'm loading it now. So click on save and close now. Let me give the data access also for this now. really strange. I couldn't really understand this. So OSCM role is sufficient for all the things now. I'm going to click on demo. And then I will now give a data access for this. Click on it. It does not give a data access for this. Go to the setup manager. Click on search now. It's manage data access. So manage data ECC. So manage data access for users. And then I will now add for the shipping manager also. So click on plus now. So it's a SCM00. Enter in now. Is a shipping manager. Yeah, recently created now. I don't know. Put the inventory R. And then put the 002 now. And come and click on save and close. Now you go there, click on it, and then you'll give a change org on this now. And click on this membership on clients and give a change org. 002. Click on OK now. So if you drop down, 001 is only coming. So maybe I have to log out and log in. Let me log out and log in. Sometimes when you make a major change, it is preferable to log out and log in now. So in the meantime, we'll now take a copy of the number now. So we'll now go there. 133046 is the number now. It's called Notepad. So 133046 is the one, and then the sales order number. So we'll note down on it. So the sales order number. It's not showing. If I click on done, then come out of it now. Sales order number is showing. So now go to the manage orders and then have a look at it now. So it's 97380 is the one. So 97380. These are the transfer order number. Transfer order number. So I'll now close everything. Close everything. So go there and close everything. So click on confirm and then come out of it now. And then sign in again. So go to the supply chain execution and then you go to the what's called inventory management and then go to the shipments. Click on it. And then you go there. Go to the shipments and manage shipment lines and then change the org. Click on change org. So if it drop down, 002 also has to come up. Search is not coming still now. 002, and you can search now. Still not coming. Oh God. The org is not coming at all. If you go there, go to the inventory management. Click on change org. No, 002 is coming here now. So click on OK now. I've changed the org from the inventory org. Now I go there and go to the what's called shipments now. So click on manage shipment lines. Oh, it's coming. Oh God. It's really very bad. Here it is not working. There it is working. Oh God, what to do? So right click and then duplicate now. You go there and then have a look at this number. You'll now go to the supply chain execution and then here go to the inventory management. Go to this place and then here I will now choose inventory and then you go there and then you go to the manage transfer orders. You go to the manage transfer orders and then the transfer order number is what? Go there. 133046. 133046 is the one. So click on search now. You're searching for it now. You select it and then click on the view shipments and reports receipts on the top. You select the line and then you click on the view shipments and receipts. On the view shipments and receipts, it goes over there now. And click on it. So it's not going over there. Okay, go there. It's not coming. It is not requested. Nothing is shipped, nothing is received, and nothing is delivered. So we are now going to query this. So order number equal to what? 133046 is the transfer order number. Go there. And then you make it as before, it will not work now. We are now going to pick release, pick confirm, and then ship confirm from the second order to first order. I'm in the second order, click on search now. You're going to do the pick release, pick confirm, and then ship confirmation. All of them, we are going to do in one go now. Go to actions, and then go to pick release now. Fine. Let us know pick release is the for each, which has to be picked now. Fine. So the concurrent is launched actually. And now go there, and then drop down, and then give a save and close. So it's not running, fine. That. So you go and then re-query it now. And click on it, click on search. Then see, close the concurrent is running. it will be going to stage it. It has not got staged. Fine. You click on it. And then here, if you go and then see on this place, now fine. It is not shipped at all. Fine. It is not shipped at all. Fine. Click on it. Let us now click on it and then ship it now. So click on ship confirmation. It will now be traveling towards the destination now. And destination is 001 now. So it's a warning. And then weight and volume. Weight and volume can be ignored. Fine. If there is any other warning, you have to address it. And then since the weight and volume is okay now. Fine. So click on yes now. So it's not up. And now what happens? They are concurrent to be running now. Fine. Click on it. Will now go there. It is now shipped. Then it will be sent. Ship and advice will be running. So this send ship and advice is responsible for sending the data from the second org to first org actually. And that will be reflecting over here. And go there, click on it. And then if you give it done now. So click on done. And then again click on the view ship and address. Fine. Go there. It will be reflecting over here. So you see the shipment number has got the shipment number for this consignment has got created. It is now shipped, and then it is now shipped from 001. The shipment is closed. This is the shipping method, and then this is what initial shipment. And then if you are given the transit times, it will tell you when it is going to arrive at the destination. So since it is all set in the vision, so we are using the visions one now, and then we will now have a look at it a bit later. So click on. So we'll now have a look at it a bit later. Now, what transfer order is not shipped. So it's all shipped actually. Now we have to receive it in the destination or. So let us now go and then receive it in the destination or. Right click and then duplicate now. And duplicate. So we'll now duplicate it now. We'll now go to the supply chain execution and then go to the inventory management. And then I have to change the or. This time I'll not change via inventory now. So when I'm doing it, if I manage item quantities and I'm changing the inventory, that is just not appearing at all. We'll not change the or. And drop it down and then choose the 001 now. And then click on OK now. Then we'll now go to the shipping. It's not done. Now we go there and then I go to the what's called now go to the receipts. I'm now going to receive it in the 001 or receipts. I'm now going to find it. So click receive expected shipments now. So here the transfer order number is 133006 133 and then give it app 046 will be coming automatically over here now. You can see it's not coming. So I'm in the 001 org. I'm going to receive it. Fine, click on search now. Fine. If you put off of it, it'll be coming. Fine, select it and then click on receive now. You're going to receive it now. So let us now receive it now. Fine, four quantities we are going to receive now. So click on the show receipt quantity. It will now show as four now. So it is now going to show. And then click on create receipt. And then click on what? You must enter sub inventory also. Right? It is a direct receipt routing. And so drop it down. And then choose the sub inventory where you are going to receive it now. And go to the stores. And then click on create receipt. And then do it now. Upon submission, what happens? It is now received as well as delivered. The receive and deliver are taking place in one go because sub inventory is also present. And then if you go there, it will not show you received as well as delivered also. If you have done now, it will be communicating that it is received. So again, select it and then what happens? You go there, go to the view receipts and ships. What happens? It will go there and then show you. So the transfer order activity is now complete. Now if you go to the manage sales orders, it will be showing that it will be goods are available for it. Right click and then what happens? Duplicate now. So let us now open up the sales order form and then have a look at it now. Click on it. So I'll now go to the order management and then I go to the what's called order management and then query this order. The order number is what? It is 973801. I go there. It's at 973801. I enter it now. So we're going to enter it now. Let's click on it. And then you go to the actions and then go to the switch to fulfillment view. And go there. So click on the fulfillment view and then have a look at it now. And then click on the fulfillment view. And then here, what happens? You go to the supply lines and then it was awaiting supply. Now it will not say goods are available for you to ship actually. It was initially awaiting supply. Now it has become goods are available. So let us now go and then ship it to the customers actually. Right click and then duplicate now. Let us now ship it to the customer. So you go to the supply chain execution and then here you go to the inventory management. And then we are going to ship it to the customer. Fine, click on it now. And then go there. I will now choose what shipments now. Fine, shipments. Go there and then here we are going to do the shipments and then click on the manage shipments. Now this time I'm not going to query on the transfer order, but I'm now going to query on the sales order. So 97380 is the one. So 97380 is the one. I'll click on it. And then click on search now. You're going to query it now. So 97380 is the one. I'm going to click on it. I will now go to actions and then go to pick release. Click on OK now. Now we'll now give a save and close now. So it's now staged now. Fine, go there. Click on it. I'll now do a ship confirmation. So click on ship confirmation. So all the weights and volumes are okay now. And click on yes now. So it is now shipped and then it will be running this concurrent called send shipment advice now. Click on it. We'll now have a look at the concurrent now. That will be running. So once when it runs, you can now see the sales orders coming up over here. So once when the send shipment advice runs, it will be communicating back to order entry that it has shipped actually. Send shipment advice is responsible for it now. Whereas when you receive from the, when you're making a transfer and then receiving it on the 001, it immediately communicates. There is no need for any concurrent at all. Fine. Similarly, for all the back-to-back operations of buy as well as a transfer and make, no need to run any concurrent. Only for shipment to the customers, we need to run it. Fine. Please take a note of it now. Fine. When you make a back-to-back receipt through a buy or a make or a transfer, so there is no need to run any concurrent. The system updates automatically. But when you're shipping it to your customers, the send shipment advice only will be communicating back to order entry. And similarly, for the return orders, it is a send receipt confirmation we had to run, and that only that has to be run manually. Here, send shipment advice is running automatically, whereas send receipt confirmation for a return order has to be run manually. Please take a note of whatever I speak now. Fine, that's very important. Otherwise, you'll be forgetting it, and then you'll be doing it. Fine, no, complete it. Go there, click on it. Go to the manage orders and then have a look at it. Fine. So it's now there. Fine. It's now there. And click on refresh now. Refreshing it. Thank you. Click on done now. Go there and see now. It's not shipped. It's not coming. Thank you. Now it will be going to awaiting billing. It will also go into awaiting. So go there, and then it will now go to awaiting billing because AR is fully set actually in this. Since AR is fully set, it will be going to awaiting billing. It will be interfacing it to this place. So go there. Go to actions and then go to switch to fulfillment review and then have a look at it now. In the progress, if you go to the what's called fulfillment lines and then click on the due number, you can now see that it will be going to awaiting billing. Awaiting billing, it has gone now. Now, I cannot run the what's called your import order invoice because this is not having any financials one. So let me go and then run via what's called via financials now. Fine. Yeah. So fin_impl, I will now log in. So I will now remember this number. Fine. I will now run it through fin_impl. So I'll log it out and then we have to run via this now because this is only a supply chain one now. So for the running of the financials, I will now go for fin_impl. So with this, I'm going to run it up. I've already set it up to welcome 123 and this now. So click on it. It is not running. So from here, I will not run this now. I will now go to the tools. I will now go to the schedule to process now. So go to the schedule to process. And then now I will not run it so that it will, the AR invoice gets created. And click on it now. So it's the import order invoice, the one. Import auto invoice. So go there. Business unit is US1. And give it tab now. It'll be coming. And then here it is a do now. The transaction source is do now. So distributed order orchestration. Click on submit now. So by which this will be communicating. And here this concurrent is now going to give a information to the feeder system. The feeder system is order management. So there here it will be running one more concurrent for informing the feeder system upon importing. Upon successful import, it will be informing the feeder system, which is order management. Now you're in AR now. So it will be informing the feeder system that they have successfully created an invoice. So once when the invoice is created, the line gets closed because the activity of the CSR is now coming to a conclusion now. So the line gets closed. So it's not running fine. It will inform the feeder system actually. Import order invoice is running now. So wait for some time. And then once when it completes, it will be informing the feeder system. So how module to module integration works upon. Some of them are automatic. Some of them are manual actually. Here it is automatic actually. So... you can now see this. Only for a return order, we have to manually run the send receipt confirmation. Apart from that, everything is automatic actually. So you now see, not done. So notify feeder system of receivables transactions to the order management. Fine, that is running now. So once when that runs, you will now find that this thing is completed. So order invoice is completed. Now notification is now going on now. Let us now go there. Go to the receivables and then have a look at the invoice. So we'll now go to the receivables now. Go to the receivables and then go to the billing now. The receivables billing. Now have a look at the invoice now. Click on it. Then here, you go there. You will now go to the manage transactions. And then put the number over here. Now, fine. It is 97380. 97380 is the one. And go there. I will now make this is a business unit is what? This one. Business unit is not an important one. The transaction source is important because it's a double star one now. Go there. I will now choose it as what? As a distributed order orchestration now. And go there. The double star one of them is required. And then go there, click on search now. So it will now find the invoice coming. Fine, click on it. You can now see the commercial invoice is now getting created on the fin_impl login now. So you click on the $4 is now coming. And click on the view images. You can now see this now. So the image of the invoice is now coming. Afterwards, they will now start to process the receipt, the payment collection. The revenue recognition team will be informed to collect the payment from the customers. Now, fine. Their task begins once when the invoice gets created. They may even process additionally some of the taxes and duties and other. They will now apply their advance and other things. So all the AR activities will now begin now. And then they will now present it to the customers. Fine. So now let us now log in back to our system now from FinIMPL. I will now come back to this now. Fine. So sign out and then go there. Click on it. Close it. Now, fine. Click on it. So come out of it. So the notify feeder system is responsible for it. Fine. Click on it now. Click on it. Go there. Come out of it. And then sign in again. Now. Fine. Through SEM00. I go there. And then click on sign in now. So before you begin any of the back-to-back activity, you go on then query your MSP percentage, default percentage. Right? That should point to your assignment set. Fine. Somebody might have modified it. So that is very important now. And then go there. And then we'll now have a look at our sales order. Go there. This also, I will close it now. I will now go to the what's called order management. And then the note 97380 is the one. You go to the order management 97380. You're going to query it. Click on this. And then you go to the order management now. 97380. 97380. And then click on enter now. There you go. So go there, and then here line is closed, and then we have to close the header now. Fine, right click and then close the header now. And duplicate now. Close the header. So when all the lines are closed, then only you can close the header. Otherwise, it's not possible now. Go to the schedule. If there are multiple lines, you have to close all the lines. Go there. Click on the schedule new process. Go there, and then it's what's called something here. I forgot the kind of name now. It's update this. Update. Slash close, isn't it? And something like that. Update slash close or what? And now say update space close. Click on search now. Update space close. The sales order. It's not coming. So click on search now. Update. So update close sales order. I don't know if I'm going to do it now. It's not giving anything at all. Give a cancel. And then along go there, remove it on the QPDATE and then give a tab now. So in the update, how many are there? You know, see this. Sometimes it causes a big problem. So let me go there and then again come back to this one now and click on it. Sometimes it causes a big problem and doesn't show you properly actually. So I will now go to the order management and then order management here. And then again come back and then do it. Now and click on it. And now come back again. So for the tools, some workaround you have to make now, right? Then it'll all be okay. Schedule new process. Update and close now. Fine. Update and then give a tab. So it has to work now. Fine. Oh God, the search results are not coming at all. Oh, struggled hard to get this now. Fine. Update or close sales orders. Fine. Come on, okay, now. So go there. I will now put the header over here now. GADER. And then remember, I have no interval is now, I made it zero now. This is one thing I made it. So header, I got to close now. So click on all the lines which are closed, the headers will be closed by this concurrent. If there are some 15 sales orders are there, out of which 12 are having all the lines as closed, those lines will be getting closed actually. So it is update space R space close sales order. Fine, orders. So it's not running. So once the concurrent completes it, you can now see your header will be getting closed. Put that wait hours as 0 hours now. Not completed. So we'll now go there and then refresh it. Now fine. The header has to get closed. It's closed actually. Fine. So we will now have a look at the setups which are required for it because we have worked on a vision and then everything is set actually. So tomorrow morning, we will now have a look at the setups for this back-to-back transfer. Bye for now. And then we'll now meet again.